There's a new feature in the latest version of Mocha Pro called PowerMesh, which means you can track non-rigid objects, like a face or cloth, for example. The mesh that's created can be imported into Blender, where you can project a texture onto it for some fun results. Here's how to do it. In Mocha, select what you want to track the way you normally do it in Mocha. Select the type of motion and size of motion. Then you enable mesh. You can either have Mocha create what it thinks is a good mesh, or you can choose uniform and set the mesh size yourself. I'm going to do that. I'll set the size to 16 to have a lot of detail. The smaller the number, the longer it takes to track though. There are tools to modify the mesh if you want to as well. Then you track it. You can go forwards and backwards. Export to an alembic mesh data file. Here you can set reference frame. If I understand it right, this will be the default shape of your mesh, so it's a good idea to use the frame that we will be painting on later. I'll be painting on the first frame in this case. In Blender, we can import the alembic file, and there's our mesh. The camera, though, is imported looking the wrong way. Select the camera, press R for rotate, press Y to only rotate on the Y axis, and type in 90 for 90 degrees. Also, make sure Blender's render size is set to the same as your footage, or at least the same aspect ratio so everything lines up. To check everything is correct, select the camera and press Ctrl+0 to make it the active camera. Set the background of the camera to your footage. Yep. Now we can open up the first frame in an image editor and we can add a mustache, a soul patch, a tattoo, a pimple, and why not connect the eyebrows? Turn off the background layer and export just the stuff we added with a transparent background. In Blender, go to the corresponding frame, in this case, the first one, go into edit mode, select the whole mesh, and set UV project from view. Now we create a texture for our mesh and import our image. You're going to have to make sure the image has transparency by setting up your nodes in the shader editor like this. Now you can either comp this together right in Blender, or you can render it out and put together in a compositor like Fusion or After Effects. And boom! Now Mocha is great, but it isn't the cheapest software out there, so can you do something similar if you have no money? Yeah, we can use EbSynth. It's in some ways a simpler process, but it is much more limited. Convert your image to an image sequence. EbSynth can't work with video files. Then take the image we created earlier and save it, but with the background on this time. It should look like how you want the final result to look like. You have to give it the exact same name as the corresponding frame in your video. In my case, it's this name. Select where to export to and press Synth. The result is blurrier and not as good as Mocha. You often get artifacts, but you can do some interesting things with this too. If things break too much, there is the option of adding more keyframes, but that means you have to manually create a new image for every keyframe. But that is how it can be done.